Everybody, welcome back. My name's Alison, the online piano and the online violin tutor. Today I'm going to take you through an easy Shut Up and Dance by Walk the Moon violin tutorial. If you want to know where to get the copy of this music that I've done for you, it's free to print out and download as usual, and I'll put a link in the description bar directly underneath this video from where you can get this. If you want to see the violin performance video of this, I'll put a link that you can click on directly above or just by the side of me here, or if you can't get annotations, I'll put a link directly underneath the video as well. And if you want to learn how to play this on the piano, I've also got a really easy piano tutorial on this as well, and that will also be linked directly underneath this video. So if you want to know how to play Shut Up and Dance on the violin, then grab your copy of the music and let's get going. Okay, just before I take you through parts of the performance, I'm just going to quickly explain what I've done with the music, just for anybody that doesn't know. What you'll notice is that every single note has all the finger numbers directly above, so you know exactly what fingers you're going to be playing for every note, and above that is going to tell you exactly what string you're going to be on. So for example, the first note is an open D, the second one is a second finger on A, third also on A, third on A, third on A, third on A, they're all on the A string until you get to here, which is an open E, then back on third on A, third, 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 and so on. So you're going to be staying on the same string until it tells you to change otherwise. This follows all the way through, so there's two pages long, so you can follow this exactly as the music goes through if you want to play it along with a backing track or something like that. The original was in the key of C sharp major. Nobody wants to play this in the key of C sharp major, me included, trust me. So I changed it to the key of D major. So if you want to play it along with the backing, you won't be able to with this music because it is in a different key. However, you might be able to get a backing in another key or get someone to change it in another key, that kind of thing. So I'm not going to play it through because I've already got a video on this which will be linked directly underneath this video, but I'm just going to take you through parts of the music and just tell you, just give you a few hints and tips and take you through important things I think you need to know. So I'm just going to take you through the start. Okay, so the first thing is that the second fingers on the A string need to be next to where the third finger would go. So the third finger would normally go here on this green dot, then the second finger has got to go right behind it. Not just a little bit behind it, but right behind it, almost to the point where it's pushing it out of the way. When you've got second fingers on the D string, they need to be in exactly the same place as well. You might find there are some open strings in here. If you want to swap the open strings for fourth fingers, absolutely go ahead and do that. I always put open strings in the first instance just because it's easier, and I know that if anybody wants to change it to fourth fingers, it's easy enough to do so. For example, at the start, open E doesn't sound that great, and it isn't what I would personally do. It does make it easier for anybody who's not used to sort of using the fourth finger yet, but if you want to kind of complicate it up, you could. So you could keep that on there, and that would make more sense to do that. So if you're finding that you're changing too soon from one string to another, then substitute the open string for a fourth finger, and that would be much better to do. If you want to keep it easier, just go ahead and leave the music as it is and just do those open strings. The other thing is that if you wanted to change some of the rhythm ever so slightly or some of the notes, totally go ahead and do that as well. I have just written down this music from listening to the original track on YouTube and just translating it down into notes for you. So this is just my transcription of how I've done it. Sometimes when singers sing these songs, they are quite difficult to put into one single melodic line because there are lots of things that you can do with the voices or with your voice that you can't necessarily do with a piano or a violin or, you know, something like that. So if you want to change some of the rhythms ever so slightly, totally go ahead and do that if you feel that it sounds a lot better. Ideally, if you know the words and you know how this goes, it should be sort of fairly easy to change and, you know, put in a couple of extra notes or just slightly tweak the rhythm to how you know it goes in your head. There is a little bit on the second page, the third and the fourth line. I've put a little bracket there. That is where the kind of guitar instrumental happens. I have left that in because I thought if there's anybody out there that wants to have a go at playing it, they can do. If not, if you think that's too difficult, because it is very fast, I will admit it is quite difficult. It's there's lots of notes there in a very short space of time. So if you wanted to leave that out, what you want to do is at bar 58, in other words, the start of the third line on the second page, leave out the whole of the third line and leave out the next 1, 2, 3 bars on the fourth line. So in other words, you come in where you've got those Ds. So you just come in where you hear the tune again there. But I've just, again, I've put brackets in there. So I've left it in if anybody wants to have a go at playing that. But I've also bracketed it out in case you don't want to do it. So if you don't want to do it, just follow it through. Or you can count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 bars rest if you want to. And then you come in on the next bar as normal. So that's it really. There isn't anything else kind of tricky about this piece. Again, it's more, there looks like there's a lot of notes there, but the notes are all pretty much repetitive. And again, if you know this song, it should be sort of easy to help guide your way through now you've got this. So thanks very much for watching. I hope you've enjoyed this. Don't forget, all the links are gonna be in the description bar directly underneath this video. And I will see you in the next video.